Konnichiwa, Samurai Appliance Repairman here. Today we're going to talk about how to get the Jenn-Air, Maytag, Amana refrigerators that use the so-called Jazz control board into self-test mode. This can be tricky unless you just look out for a couple things that I'm going to show you. First of all, I want to show you what the Jazz control board looks like. It's usually used on the bottom mount refrigerators. This is the control board itself. This is the display for it. Okay, and I'm going to show you a refrigerator with this control installed and what that looks like. Okay, this is an Amana French door refrigerator with the bottom mount freezer, and it has the Jazz control board. You can always tell the Jazz control board. It's got the two digital, single-digit digital displays, one for the freezer, one for the refrigerator. Okay, and it also... it has this type of light grill assembly behind it. This plastic grill comes off the back. The Jazz control board is disassembled from the back. It swings down the housing in order to replace the control board when it inevitably goes bad. So this is just to show you the characteristic look of what the control board looks like to tell whether or not you have the Jazz control board. I'm going to show you another way. Okay, this is the tech sheet for the refrigerator we were just looking at. And as I mentioned, this was a bottom mount refrigerator. I believe most of the Jazz control boards are used in bottom mount refrigerators, whether or not they're French door. Some are French door or not. This one, and you can tell it's a Jazz control board, but looking at the tech sheet, because if you come down here and look, let me get that to focus, it says right there, Jazz PCB. Printed circuit board. So this one, this is how you can tell whether or not your refrigerator uses the Jazz control board. Where do you find the tech sheet for your refrigerator? Come with me now on a journey of total appliance enlightenment while I show you where the tech sheet for your refrigerator lives, but only if you promise to put it back when you're done. So remove the tow grill from the very bottom. This is the freezer door here. Right below the freezer door, there's going to be a tow grill. You're going to find lots of dog hair, particularly if you have a German Shepherd. Yow, this one really needs cleaning. Okay, don't say anything to my customer. Whoa. But you're also going to see a hair-covered cellophane package in which resides the tech sheet that we were just looking at. I used a knife to cut it open in order to remove the tech sheet. Now, because I'm a good, honest technician with good character integrity, I will always replace the tech sheet. Let me tell you, there's a lot of sleazebag techs out there. They're not even techs. They're just parts-changing monkeys who steal the tech sheets. They don't even know how to read the tech sheets, don't know what to do with them. They just steal them. They go, ooh, valuable information. Okay, if you're one of those people watching this movie, I don't think very much of you. But for the rest of you, just a good tip to return it back. It's put down here for a reason, so it's always available when you need it. Let's go back to the tech sheet. Okay, so we're back at the tech sheet here, and we are starting on page 1. So we're going to go back, page 2, page 3, page 4. Which is the last page of this first section. But again, these are not independent sections. They just happen to be printed this way because the next section begins page 5. And this tells us on page 4, service test mode and how to get into it. So, and to get into service test mode, we're going to hold the refrigerator door light switch closed while we press the refrigerator temperature up button 3 times consecutively within 10 seconds. And then release the refrigerator door light switches, and you're going to see SE in the display. Let's do that now. Okay, so this, as I mentioned earlier, this particular refrigerator is a French door unit. So it will have 2 light switches, one for each door. A single door fresh food compartment will only have 1 light switch to worry about. So the procedure here is you've got to hold both of these down in the case of a French door fridge and then press the refrigerator temperature up button 3 times within 10 seconds. Let's do that now. And there we are. We see that we're in SE, service entry mode, which will actually be the numeral 5, but that is supposed to be an S and E. So right now, we are in service entry mode. And to get out, we're just going to pretend like we close the doors, open them, and there we are back in normal mode. So just to review some of the things that you can do, you can test the defrost thermostat and defrost circuit in service mode. You can test the compressor, condenser fan, evaporator freezer fan test. You can test the fresh food thermistor, the freezer thermistor. These are just pass-fail. Just be advised that this will not tell you whether they've gone out of spec. It's just simply going to tell you whether they're open or shorted. Thermistors can commonly fail, most commonly, in fact, fail by going out of spec. The resistance increases, but not to the point of being open. You can test the damper, and you can do even adjustments on the cold control. And another wiring diagram in the back. So there you go. You have successfully entered service test mode on your Maytag Amana Jenn-Air refrigerator with the Jazz control board. Just remember to replace the tech sheet back where you got it underneath the refrigerator. And go ahead and pop a cold one. Beer.